G'day, welcome to Art with Alison. Today I'm doing rather a large canvas, biggest one I think that I've ever done. This is 60 centimetres by 75 centimetres, or approximately 24 inches by 30 inches. So, because it's so big, I'm just going to spray the back of the canvas with some water. Apparently that helps to tighten the canvas. And I'm going to cover the canvas now in a white base. I'll get back to you when I finish doing that. Okay, so cover the canvas in white paint. It's a fairly liquidy white paint. And I'm going to be doing, as I said, a funnel pour. So need to first of all pour a nice big puddle. And then pop the funnel basically straight down onto the canvas. I've just got nice little handles on this, so I'll just hold it by a handle. Lift it up slightly. So I'll start off. I'm just using Eraldo paints, except for a bit of mixed gold from DecoArt. So I start off with some Eraldo White, followed by Eraldo Cool Blue. Basically just layering them at this stage. And then some Eraldo Magenta. These are all, these colours are mixed with Floetrol. 1-to-1, no water added. And this is purple, Eraldo purple. And I'll just put some gold in. I might let the gold tip from up high a bit. White. And blue. So you can see it's not coming out the bottom at this stage because it is on the canvas. Magenta, and purple, alright, let's take a bit more white around it, particularly on this side because that's the direction I'm going to head in, and I'll just start lifting it up very slightly. It's just starting to come out the bottom, and I'll just move it along slowly. Just going to make sure there's enough white in front and around. I'll just put some more white in front. Move it forward a bit more. That. So some magenta, purple, white. Blue, gold, and I'll do it again. such a big canvas, so I'm going to have to do this a few times. Right, start with some blue. I've got another paint made up. Magenta. Purple. Add some red this time and some black. And now some gold. And some white in front. And off we go again. Running out. Magenta. Purple. Some white in. Gold. Plenty of white in front. Basically, you've got to just keep lifting it up slightly whilst moving it. The joy of this is you can just go wherever you want. It's easy to move it. Make sure there's enough white in front. I might just leave it at that for the minute. Put in something. Catch the drips. Unless the dogs have come inside. I'll torch it first. This not only helps pop any air bubbles, but it will help bring up any cells underneath. Colors have different densities, and some rise more than others, basically, especially when they're heated. Right, well, let's start tipping and see what happens. Canvas. placed on the ground. It's easier on my back. Pretty colours. I might just let that run off the corner. Best to do this now. Snoring's a dog, if you're wondering. Wow, that's looking quite pretty. Alright, I'm going to walk around and keep it from the other side. Go down that corner, shall bring the weight of the paint back to the center. It's always a good idea to do that because otherwise everything can get mucked up. The soles end up funny shapes and it just helps keep it going ziggity zaggity as well. Alright, I'll get that down to that corner. All this over here. Pull that down, see if I can. I just go over a bit and then tip it a tiny bit. Hopefully, it will slide more easily. Get more paint on there and it slides more easily. Snoring dog. Right. Hopefully it'll slide without losing all the rest of that side. Good. Right. Bring it back. Just need to walk around again. So now I want to try and just get the weight of the paint back up there a bit. I'll keep it going. Okay, I think I might leave that white up that end and just bring it down to this corner. Doing that, I'll straighten out the plastic. I just put the, because I already had some paint from a previous pour, but I scraped most of it up, but I didn't. Anyway, reasons I'll explain later, I just got the, so I'm trying to concentrate on what I'm doing while talking at the same time. Not always easy. Go right to the corner. I just, the plastic that came off the canvas, I've put that over the top. All right. Just go around and tip it back a bit. Not quite over. All right. I'll just tip it that tiny bit more. See from so far away. It really is hard to see. What is going on over there? I should have done it by now. Don't want to use too much off there. Ooh, wow. Loving it. Wow, who'd have thought funnels are such fun? Oh goodness, this is only the second funnel pour I've done. I had a practice earlier on a smaller piece and just loved that, and I'm wanting to enter just a local art exhibition, and wanted another painting to submit, and yay, this is going to be it. I have to get the submission in tonight before midnight, and it's now 10:45 or so, yeah. nothing like leaving it to the last minute, so I'm glad it's turned out. I could have chosen something else, but no, this is great. Alright, I'll bring you in for a close-up. Okay, so here's some close-ups. Looks gorgeous. It's quite pretty. I'm thinking this looks like water and rocks and zoom it. Maybe. It's a bit hard. It's such a big canvas. I can't. No, it's above my head. But maybe it's like cascading water flowing down. Like a waterfall, maybe. Or because down there, I think that looks a bit like water after it's come from a waterfall. Anyway, that's just what I think. Different people see different things in different artworks. It looks better actually as all one picture. But wow, that's actually really pretty, isn't it? Mind you, what
This looks a lot more purple than what I'm seeing. I'm seeing a much richer gold, whereas on the screen it looks almost green, whereas it doesn't look green at all on the canvas. Maybe once it's dried and it's in the sunlight, rather than the middle of the night with artificial lights, we'll be able to get a better understanding of the colours. Anyway, that was a lot of fun and I enjoyed it a lot and look forward to doing more of them. Alright, well, thanks heaps for watching and catch you again soon. Bye! Here's the dried result, taken outside.